Hey, it's Jeff, everyone, and on today's Disney Roundup, I'm going to be telling you how you can celebrate the 2019 holiday season at Walt Disney World and at Disneyland Resort. We also have a first look at one of the Marvelland-themed attractions, and sad to say, but over this past week, we lost a Disney legend and the voice of Minnie Mouse. We have all that and more right here on the DRU. Hey everyone, and welcome to this week's episode of the Disney Roundup, where I will be bringing you up to date on what's going on with the Walt Disney Company and Disney Parks each and every single week. If you're new to my channel, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button for me so you can stay up to date with the Disney Roundup and some other cool videos I'll be posting along. And unfortunately, the first news we have to report this week is the passing of Russi Taylor, the voice actress and Disney legend. She passed away last week on July 26, 2019 in Glendale, California, and she was at the age of 75 when she passed. Now, she is known for doing many different voices, but most notably, Minnie Mouse. She once said, "I never wanted to be famous. The characters I do are famous, and that's fine for me." She's also appeared in many different films, direct-to-video, TV, and even video games and theme park attractions. She was nominated for many awards, including Emmys, and was presented with the Disney Legends Award in 2008. Now, I believe Bob Iger, who is the CEO and president of the Walt Disney Company, put this best, and that was, "Minnie Mouse lost her voice with the passing of Russi Taylor. For more than 30 years, Minnie and Russi worked together to entertain millions around the world, a partnership that made Minnie a global icon," which I believe was perfectly said by Bob Iger. Well said. And now to move along with company news, if you're going to be at the D23 Expo, you're going to get the chance to be one of the first people to check out the Disney Plus streaming service. They will be having a preview showcase this year happening on Friday, August 23rd at 3:30 p.m. and guests in attendance will get to come see never-before-seen content. There's also a Disney Plus Pavilion where there will be demonstrations on how the app works and special offers for early subscribers. I wish I could go to this. I'm really looking forward to the Disney Plus streaming service and all of the original and all of the new content that's coming. I'm just anxious to see too. I know the starting price for this for the Disney Plus will be $6.99 a month, and you're getting a lot with this. I mean, it shows right here, you're gonna get Disney, you're gonna get Pixar, you're gonna get Nat Geo, you're gonna get Lucasfilm, Marvel, all of that. So I'm wondering how long it's gonna stay at $6.99 a month before it goes up. Let me know in the comments down below what you think. Now for outside of the parks news. Disney's Earport Store over at the MCO Airport is to close for refurbishment. Now, for those of you who don't know, over at the Orlando International Airport, Disney has a store there over, I believe it's at the Hyatt Tower area. And this is a great place to go if you want to get some early souvenirs before you begin your vacation, or if you're leaving and you forgot to get something or forgot to get something for someone, this is a good place to stop in, pick up something real quick, and then start or end your vacation. And from my experience from being in this store and other Disney shops, I compare this more to, it's kind of like one of the stores inside of resorts, I would say. They have the same type of merchandise in there, you know, like t-shirts, towels, coffee mugs, essentials, all that good stuff in there. But the whole store will be going under refurbishment and is currently said to reopen this year in 2019. Now for parks news. We now have our first look at one of the Marvelland themed attractions over at Disney California Adventure. Over this past week, concept art was revealed for the Spider-Man attraction ride vehicles by Walt Disney World News Today. And this is for the Worldwide Engineering Brigade attraction, or otherwise known as the W.E.B attraction, which will be themed after Spider-Man. It's said to allow guests to have the ability to sling webs and do more during this attraction, just as if they were Spider-Man in this what's said to be an interactive 3D attraction. The concept art that was revealed shows the queue in red and blue pod-like vehicles, which look like they will be able to hold up to 4 guests. Now, this is all that we've heard and seen of this attraction so far, but I expect come the D23 Expo at the end of August, they will be revealing more information on this. And I hope they reveal more information on what's to come with the Marvel Land over at Disney California Adventure as well, because I'm really looking forward to seeing how that land turns out. Also, a quick note I want to make is that this Friday, August 2nd, Disney Parks Live will be going live to show the first reshowing of the Main Street Electrical Parade over at Disneyland. Recently, Disney Parks announced the return of the Main Street Electrical Parade at Disneyland this summer, and this is going to be running from August 2nd all the way up until September 30th of this year. And if you're unable to make it during this limited time return, Disney Parks will be airing the parade this Friday, August 2nd, 2019 at 8:55 Pacific time. So if you're on the East Coast like I am, be ready and stay up late for a long night if you want to see the return of this legendary parade. Now, if you're going to be over at Disneyland during the holiday season, here are some of the transformations you can look forward to seeing. Disneyland Resort will turn into the merriest place on earth starting November 8th until January 6th. At Disneyland Park, holiday magic shines brightly with the glistening Sleeping Beauty's Winter Castle, and returning this year, entertainment includes Believe and Holiday Magic, a fireworks spectacular, and a Christmas fantasy parade. In addition, with one-of-a-kind seasonal transformations will once again take over It's a Small World Holiday and Haunted Mansion Holiday, which I love the Haunted Mansion Holiday overlay that they do over there, because they always include that huge gingerbread house inside the Haunted Mansion. If you've never seen it or checked it out before, go and experience that. It's nothing like you've seen before. And over at Disneyland California Adventure, World of Color will turn into World of Color. Season of Light will dazzle with its holiday-themed spectacular of lights, lasers, water, fire, and hundreds of fountains, bringing animation to life. Festival of Holidays also returns, bringing the spirit of the season to life through sights, sounds, and tastes of Christmas, Navidad, Hanukkah, Diwali, Kwanzaa, and Three Kings Day from January 3rd to the 6th. For residents of Cars Land, two attractions rely on holiday magic to transform into Luigi's Joy to the World and Mater's Jingle Jamboree. So if you're going to be heading over to Disneyland during the holiday season this year, what are you looking forward to the most? Let me know in the comments down below. And now, if you're going to be over at Walt Disney World for the holiday season in 2019, here's some of the stuff you can look forward to there. First off, there are holiday overlays coming to Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party. For the first time ever, during Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party, select nights at the Magic Kingdom attractions are receiving special enhancements just for the holidays. Get behind the wheel on the Tomorrowland Speedway. You'll find yourself cruising a festive freeway filled with thousands of lights and stylized decor. The crew members at Monsters, Inc. Laugh Floor is putting some ha 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 in their ho 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 with the new show for everyone visiting the Monsters World during Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party. Space Mountain launches you on a trippy jaunt through the cosmos filled with dazzling lighting and high-energy holiday tunes, and Mad Tea Party in Fantasyland becomes a wild and wacky Christmas party as you spin your teacups to one of four new holiday combos of lights and music. What I've noticed with these attractions that they're giving overlays to, they're giving them different overlays at other special ticket events like Mickey's Not-So-Scary Halloween Party suit. Because they're giving Monsters, Inc. Laugh Floor a new overlay this year during the Halloween party. We've seen just last year they gave a different overlay of sounds and music to the teacups, and the same with Space Mountain. So I wonder if they're going to stick with these theming or just these attractions to give different overlays to. But I wonder, I got to thinking about it too. Really, without changing the theming of the attractions too much, these are really the only attractions you can change up without having to really change up the ride and the story of the attraction itself. So let me know in the comments down below what you think of this, and if there are any other attractions you'd like to see have an overlay. Also new to this year, there's also a new fireworks show. It is Minnie's Wonderful Christmas Time Fireworks Show, debuting this year. And there are plenty of returning favorites like Frozen Holiday Wish, Mickey's Most Merriest Celebration, A Totally Tomorrowland Christmas, Club Tinsel, and the Disney Junior Jingle Jam, and Mickey's Once Upon a Christmas Parade, not to mention sparkling decor, complimentary treats, and a magical snowfall on the Main Street, USA. Also outside of the Magic Kingdom, returning to Hollywood Studios this year is Jingle Bell, Jingle Bam, along with Sunset Season's Greetings will be returning to Hollywood Studios this year as well. Now, Jingle Bell, Jingle Bam is the nighttime show that takes place at the Chinese Theater, and Sunset Season's Greetings is the nighttime color projection show that happens on the Hollywood Tower Hotel. And if you're looking to spend your Christmas at Walt Disney World, under special offers on Walt Disney World's website, you can now purchase the Ultimate Disney Christmas Package. With this, you can celebrate the magic of the holidays in the most magical place on Earth with the Ultimate Disney Christmas Package at Walt Disney World. Check in from December 21st to December 26, 2019, and enjoy an itinerary of full festive fun in between. Now with this package, it includes a 5-night stay at a select Disney resort hotel and a 4-day theme park ticket with a park hopper option. Now with this package, it does include some exclusive experiences that you can take in, and first off being that the Saturday, December 21st, an exclusive nighttime access to ride Avatar, Flight of Passage, Navi River Journey, and Expedition Everest at Disney's Animal Kingdom theme park. Plus catch in an exclusive showing of the park's new Rivers of Light, We Are One show. On Sunday, December 22nd, 2019, you get tickets to Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party at the Magic Kingdom. Monday, December 23rd, or Tuesday, December 24th, Christmas Eve, you will have access to an exclusive reserved viewing area to watch Epcot Forever, an all-new nighttime spectacular. Plus, each guest ages 3 and up will receive a digital $50 Epcot-themed Park Dine promo code to use at participating Epcot locations. And to top it all off, on Wednesday, December 25th, Christmas Day, an Ultimate Disney Christmas gift is delivered to your room hotel. And no further details on what that could be have been announced yet. But for this, you can book through for this offer until October 26th of 2019. Prices for this are really expensive. It starts at $199 a person per night. In total, it starts at $3,980 and go up to $345 a person per night for a total of $6,900. And that depends on what resort you stay at. You have 4 selections of resorts you can choose from in this package. And for more information on that, I will leave links and more information in the description as well if you're interested. All right, everyone. Well, that's all I have for you for this week's episode of the Disney Roundup. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button for me and subscribe to my channel to receive the Disney Roundup each and every single week. And until next time, we'll see you on the DRU.